Matawona,
Matawona,
Matawona. Lift up those hands and let us call upon the name of the Lord. He's worthy, he's worthy, he's worthy. Yeah. Jesus, we bless you. We must say there was your gloomy Zemukama. Mugambe, you go with Kakabaka. You go Katonda Wamawanga Gona. Yegwafuge mirembe n'emirembe. Teri mulala okujjako gwe Yesu. Teri mulala afuga. Teri mulala asaanidde. Teri mulala agwana matendo. Teri mulala agwana kitiibwa. Teri linnya ligwanidde kuyimusibwa okujjako eriryo Yesu. Osaanidde ayi Kabaka wa bakabaka. Osaanidde Katonda wa Isirayiri, Isaaka ne Yakobo. Osaanidde gwasokera asemba. Osaanidde gwamanyi byonna era ebirimu byonna. Osaanidde gwe Katonda afuga waggulu mu ggulu ne wansi w'ensi. Osaanidde gwe Katonda afuga agayanja aganene n'ensozi ennene. Osaanidde gwe Katonda yatonda ensi n'okujjula kwayo kwonna. Osaanidde gwe yeetooloddwa amaanyi. Osaanidde gwe kige ky'amaanyi gye tuddukira ne twekweka. Mukwano gwange yimusa eddoboozi ly'omuwa ekitiibwa kubanga oyo yekka yekka y'asaanidde. O sarirereboosa yalabashikataya. Osaanidde Kabaka wa bakabaka, tukuwa ekitiibwa. Yegwe Kabaka w'amawanga gonna. Yegwe afuga lero encha n'eluli. Yegwe Kabaka wa bakabaka. Yegwe abifuga emirembe gyonna lero n'eluli. Njagala tuyimbe ekyo kyokka. Yegwe Kabaka w'amawanga gonna. Yimusa mikono mugambe yegwe Kabaka. Yegwe afuga lero encha n'eluli. Yegwe Kabaka. Yegwe Kabaka w'abakabaka. W'abakabaka yegwe abifuga. Yegwe afuga emirembe gyonna. baka wabaka baka yegwe afuga lelo enchaneluni yegwe kabaka wabaka baka yegwe afuga mieme jona lelo neluni mana gwe liga hatula nechita fe gwe kabaka yesu gwe kabaka mana gwe Yesu kwe kabaka Lamb of God who sits on the right hand of the Father, you are holy, holy, you are holy, Lamb of God. Yesu mutukuvu, wange mutukuvu, imwana kwe ndiga, hatula nechitafe mutukuvu, holy mutukuvu. Both hands, and I want us to make a declaration, because there is no one like our God. You are God from beginning to Take the Holy Ghost. What would have become of me if I didn't see your light? What would have been said of me if you didn't hold my hand? Now I've come to testify that you are all I have. Yes, you are. You are all that matters. What will I gain if you take the Holy Ghost? What will I become of me if I didn't see your light? What would have been said of me if you didn't hold my hand? Now I've come to realize that you're
matters, Lord. Nothing else. You are everything, Jesus. Father, we thank you for this day. We give you glory, Lord, and we give you praise. Thank you, Lord, for all that you are doing and for all that you are yet to do. May this Sunday service, may this day of awakening be a day that you have chosen to abide in the praises of your people. Be exalted and be magnified. Cause your name to be glorified in this place. Just you to the Lord, take a minute or two to you to him and celebrate him and bless his holy name, magnify his holy name. He is all there is, mighty God, mighty warrior. We love you, Lord. We thank you for your goodness and for your kindness. Came from your home with an urge, with a demand, with a passion to meet with God. But today I want to ask you to lift up your hands and tell him what you want him to do in your life this day. Every day is a new day. Every time he appears in his presence is a new moment. Bible says his mercies are new every morning. And even this morning there is a new mercy. There is a new grace. There is a new level. So just you to him and surrender to him. And let God have his way this day. Tell him, Lord, where will I be without you? What can I get if you don't give it to me? You know everything about me. You know me when I wake up and when I stand up. You know me when I lie down and there is nothing I can know in the world. But still you keep me safe. I am not the best driver. I'm not the best foot speech person. Lord. People walk on the road and they are knocked even in their homes. People drive and they find accidents each and every moment. But who am I? That a God of all the earth. Lord, you are a wonderful, merciful Savior. And even as we sing to this chorus, Holy Spirit, we want to affirm to you that we are yours and yours forever. The choir can give us a song, Wonderful Merciful Savior.
Wonderful Merciful Savior, precious Redeemer and Friend. Who would have thought that the Lamb could rescue the soul of men? Oh, rescue the souls of men. You are the one, you are the one that we praise. You are the one we adore. You give the healing and grace. Hearts always hunger.
Just wave to him and tell him, Lord, I love you. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for your goodness. Thank you for your kindness. Thank you for your divine nature and your divine ability in my life. We love you, Lord, and we celebrate you. And the name of the Lord shall be glorified in Jesus' mighty name. Why don't you appreciate God with a shout of praise and shouts of adoration, bless his holy name. Can we appreciate the Fountain of Praise Choir? Thank you so much. And the wonderful team here, we thank you all. Thank you for being here this morning. It's a day filled with a lot of activities, but edifying activities, spiritual activities. It's a day of transformation. It is a day of an encounter with God. You cannot come to these services today and go back the same. Tell your neighbor, I refuse to go back the same. Tell your neighbor, I refuse to go back the same way I came. I will do whatever it takes to meet with God this morning. So we want to welcome, this is Christian Discipleship Ministries International, led by our pastor, Apostle Michael Chimuli, and Mami Sarah. So we are glad to welcome you yet to this wonderful day God has blessed us today. It is a day where we have our Father in the Lord, Apostle John Bonjo. He is already here in the office. He will be speaking to us shortly. He's going to be with us almost the entire day. He will speak again in the second service. And then after the second service, we are going to have Pork Muchomo, Pork Roasted Pork. I don't know whether some of you have been to Pork Planet where there is Pork Buffet. So today there is going to be goat, muchomo, everything, not going home. So some of you, we ask you that if you can stay until evening, please, lunch will be provided. Mrs. Musamba promised us juice yesterday according to the word of our fathers. I think there will be juice here somewhere. So we expect to have juice here in this place. It's going to be powerful today. I'm very certain. I know there are some habitual people who come for the first service and they are seated somewhere. But today, if you can stretch a bit and hear from what the Father has to speak to us. I know every time God sends a man of God in our midst, He sends him for someone, not for everyone. You never know, this could be your service or the next service or the afternoon. Today is power packed. We have Apostle John Bunji, Apostle Michael Chimoli, we have Pastor Bugembe, we have Pastor Ian Bana. What a day. If I were here, I would celebrate the anointing upon the servants of God. Mark Bioko Mungareza Man, hallelujah. Ngambira buli muntu ali ku simu akubireko mukama engalo ez'amaanyi. Haleluya. Mukube engalo za mukama, nzuulire nga za mukama. Glory to Jesus. Why? Because the anointing you celebrate is what impacts your life. So if you don't celebrate the anointing on this man of God, you'll go back the same way you came. But if you place a demand on them and a place a demand on God, you will get something. Hallelujah. Just imagine if a normal man what was his name? Isaac. A fellow man came and told him, "My father, don't you have anything left for me?" And the man told him, I've given your brother custody over you. Every one of you and every other person will be his server, will serve him. He said, "No, I still know you can give me something." So if a fellow man can demand something from a fellow man, what about what if we place a demand on someone we know can give us something today that is tangible? Hallelujah. So we trust the Lord. Apostle Bunjo is going to speak to us. He's going to turn this place around for the glory of God. Hallelujah. So I want you to raise your expectation. And I want to request everyone that is at home, that is trying to dress up, to come here. Please run, because in the afternoon we shall have an overflow here. We'll put screens outside and chairs outside, because we are expecting quite a number of people here. So if you want to keep a seat in this inside of this tent, you need to mark it with a bag. If you don't have a bag, find a way of marking your seats. Even if you go for a short call, you tell your neighbor, "I'm coming back." Hallelujah. Because of what God is about to do in this place. And now next Sunday, yesterday, our Father in the Lord impressed it upon him to talk about the significance of dedication. You know, dedication is quite amazing. People don't really forget and don't remember what happens in their private moments. But people dedicate themselves to things. They covenant, they enter into covenants with people, with things, with material possessions, and then they begin to have a hold of them. One day I have a friend of mine, is a husband to one of my friends. We happened to go there for a prayer meeting, and this is what happened. During the prayer meeting, as we were praying, the Lord opened my eyes to see. He had a pain in his stomach that started close to maybe like 15 years before, like between 10 to 15 years before that moment. And he had never told his wife and how it started. Now, there are things that only God can reveal in his presence. So that after that evening, when we were praying, the Lord showed me what had happened to him. So when I pointed it out, the man was dozing. He became very sober. Tell him, but sometimes you can be dozing, but when the anointing comes and they speak out what is on you, you sober up. Hallelujah. So the man sobered up and he began to open up, and he said, one day, how it started, he went to rent a place in Nakawa, that side. And in that house, the landlord had covenanted that house to a spiritual being. So the spiritual being would turn either a woman or a man in that house into either a wife or a man. So it would make use of everyone. And now it would come and initiate you in the night by feeding you things in the night. You wake up, from that time when he was fed, he began having stomach pain. I would go to hospitals and they could not cure the pain in the stomach. And now this is what happened. Every night this spiritual being would come and use him. He wasn't born again and didn't know what to do. Later on, the wife became born again, but then they shifted. But even after they shifted, the spiritual being still monitored him. And that is what our Father was talking about, is that you can be dedicated knowingly or unknowingly. She entered into something he didn't even have a clue about by renting a house. And now he took another grace upon a man of God and he was set free. Today is totally free. That night the Lord healed him of the stomach pain. The spiritual being never came back. So when you are dedicated to something, you need another higher anointing to set you free. So this coming Sunday on the 19th, we shall have two services here. And the only purpose will be to lay hands on you. Our Father will speak about dedication. And he also said, as you prepare to come for this dedication service, prepare your dedication seed. You know, in the Bible, we see people coming to dedicate, but with some a substance, because dedication has to have a sacrifice, has to have a seed for it to be very effective. So I'm asking us this coming Sunday, apart from this Sunday, prepare your seed of dedication. Some of you, someone took a chicken to a witch doctor to put you into your bondage. So you also need to take a seed in the presence of a man of God and tell the Lord, this must end here. So this coming Sunday is going to be powerful. So the way we are crowning this year is going to be amazing. Can somebody say amen? Can I hear someone say amen? So we want to appreciate every one of you that has been with us during this awakening week. It's been a week of power, and I know many of you have so many wonderful testimonies. Can we first appreciate God for the servants of God that have been speaking to us from Sunday to Tuesday? We want to appreciate God for our mother in the Lord. Mommy, you're welcome. Pastor Tamale, together with the wife, is somewhere. You're welcome, Silva. Lord Akon, we are glad to have you this morning. I know we shall have another round of tests. I want to have just two people who I promise to allow to testify in this service on a Sunday. And then I'll come back and tell you the hymn choir, sound of the hymn choir, they're going to bless us in few songs as we get ready to receive the servant of God. So if you have a testimony and God has done something tremendous in the year, maybe you wanted to testify last Sunday and you couldn't have an opportunity, I want to allow you to testify to the goodness of the Lord in the name of Jesus. If you're there, please rise up on your feet. Don't wait for your neighbor to stand up, because you know what the Lord has done in your life. Can somebody say amen? Can somebody say amen? So if you're here and you want to give glory to Jesus, we want to bless the Lord for you, because God has kept you. God has kept you moving. You are what you are because of God. Hallelujah. I was talking to a friend of mine, and we're just talking about how prayer taught children can cause tremendous results. He told me these days he doesn't struggle with prayer. When he wants something from God, he tells the son to pray and God answers. Praise the Lord. So some of you, you need to devise means of meeting God in either way. Hallelujah. So if you have a testimony, I want to give an opportunity to come and test. So we are constructing Mulawa, and we are making it possible, because if someone can put for us the screenshot, we want this to become your dream every night. Instead of having nightmares, you dream seeing yourself in that cathedral, entering. Hallelujah. Can we appreciate God for that? Wonderful what God is doing in this place. That cathedral is going to be open. We are entering it in glory, by fire, by thunder, by the power of the Holy Spirit. So lift up your hands and say, Lord, we shall enter. Gamba, Lord, we shall enter that cathedral. Mulawa is yours. Mulawa is for Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name. So allow me invite Mrs. Tamale and her team to bless us this Sunday morning. This is just an appetizer. This wonderful choir in the afternoon, they are going to bless us with a sound of heaven experience, a live experience. And then we shall crown it with Pastor Bugembe. So it is going to be powerful. So Mrs. T and Pastor Tamale, this is your time to come and bless us this morning in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to Jesus. As they come, our Father has written books. You know, Pastor Tamale is dressing up from church. Hallelujah. Pastor Tamale is dressing up from church. Mukubire kombo galo Pastor Tamale ayambalira mu kanisa. Omuchala teyamulabiridde bulungi, yefuddeko yekka, but we are glad. God is doing great things. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to Jesus. Can we appreciate the servants of God? Our Father in the Lord is here, and Apostle Johnny Bonjo. We are very glad to have you. These books are almost running out of stock, so you need to grab your copy before it is too late. This is Do You Know God's Voice? A Manual on Understanding the Voice of God. And then The Mystery of Gates and Foundations. Yesterday I was telling Daddy something that shook me and placed me somewhere. Someone got a visitation from the Lord, and it was about me. And the Lord showed her my house. She had never been there. And she studies from Deji University. So, and I think I'd last spoken to her for some good years. And she told me, the Lord has told me there is a book, it's a big book called Mystery of Gates and Foundations for your Father in the Lord. You bought it, but you've never read it. It is in this cabin. I got scared, Apostle Bonge, because I had bought it, but I had never literally sat down to read it. And I know many people are there. Some of you have bought this book and you've never read it. That is when I knew God wants me to learn something deeper than I've been hearing from my Father. So you need to grab these books and begin reading them before the Lord sends you a prophetic word or an angel to awaken you from your slumber. So can we join our hands as we welcome the Sound of Heaven choir as they minister to us this morning in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise God. I hope you have a wonderful night. You're all welcome.
Jesus.
My faith has found a resting place. Not in device, no creed. Are you there? John Mark, are you okay? My faith has found a resting place, not in device nor creed. I trust the ever-living One, His words for me shall plead. I need no other argument.
Jesus Christ.
nightmares and difficulties within my studies. So what I urge you is to accept Christ, because when you come to him, the things disturbing you will be sorted, and you'll even make it to heaven, in Jesus' name.
Tambulira mmasanu agensi agazira mchega sobola akola aiwe nasembeza Yesu yampe mirembe ejizira kwakoba chemba akoba banange bonabona bali eyo mwideno Yesu nawe nagabe mirembe ejayirala era mwena mwena musembeze Yesu okuba omulokozi w'obulamu bwaimwe musobola ofuna emirembe emirungi.
Saved me. He's provided me life. Today is my birthday. I'm glad I'm here serving him.
Amen.
Oh, what a wonderful, wonderful day. Day I will never forget. After I wandered in darkness away, Jesus, my Savior, I met. Oh, what a tender, compassionate friend. He met the need of my heart. Shadows dispelling the joy I am telling. He made all the darkness depart. Oh,
heavens came down and glory filled my soul.
Filled my soul.
When at the cross my Savior made me whole. My sins were washed away, and my night was done today. Heavens came down and glory filled my soul.
Calvary's love, oh, what a stunning is mine.
Jagala, yes, we jagala. kale fena tuyimireko tuyimba tutya ennyimba ezo muddeemu ekitundu kimu nga bayimiridde baliyimba omanyi befuula batumanyi bafuula batalumanyi mbamuyimba siza kwera bibinga ndimo God will give you a revelation. You'll buy the book and you sing it and you sing those songs and you feel like you are praying. Amen. So, can we give a hand clap to a wonderful choir? God bless you. Thank you so much. We're going to have them in the evening and another choir, so it's going to be powerful. Amen. As we crown this meeting. Amina, today we are extremely, extremely blessed. Amina, mkama yevaziwe. What did Jesus say that the best wine is reserved last? Amen. Do you remember that? So this is written, and we are privileged to have our own. The daddy here, the friend, the brother, and you know, the one who opened up this altar, Mkama Yebazibwe, and that is none other than Dr. Apostle John Bunjo. Hallelujah. Alinamuga sekeri nyamuita firebrand. Mamuitani, firebrand. You never know what to expect. Something can burst. Amina. Hallelujah.
Hello.
We have given him late, so we have to be patient. So today, what time we end this service? 11. God bless you. And then the other one. Temutula kumasawa, mutuli.
Ye gwe gwe ne taga jaya
Jaya.
jangu Yesu jangu tula munda yange jangu Yesu jangu tula fuge munze
sulira
jangu Yesu jangu tula munda yange
Woo! nagwendaba omusajja ayambadde byeru n'olukoma
mu kifuba lwa zaabu.
Lindako, okiyimba buyimbi oba ddala olina kyolaba? 2 years ago natandika okuyimba nga ennyimba nga nzimbira munda, so singe ebikwate oba nga enjatula. Makes sense. Badde nkiyigiriza abaana bange abayimbi ne bagamba nti, let the song, don't sing the song, let the song sing. So, this is the 8th day of this meeting. And you don't know what's going to happen for this ministry. I came here to plant this ministry from the onset. All the levels that this ministry has been going through have been part. And the third phase that this ministry is going to take, and it had to take this day. I was supposed to be here on Friday, but I had an important call, and that was not that I missed, but it was reserved for a purpose. So today, I called Pastor Chimuli a few days ago, but because he's been busy writing, of course, but I was telling him, today is a special day, it's an encounter day. And something is going to be birthed. So there's a stage. If you see me how I am, and so the atmosphere of the meeting, I don't know where it's going, but thank God I've yielded to God wholeheartedly. I fear no one. And as he says, I will say. I no longer have restrictions. Nobody controls me. I've gone through a lot to be controlled by him. There's a lot of me that he has swallowed. Like these guys that detonate bombs on their bodies. There's another side of it that we have to learn. They sell themselves wholly to Allah, that nothing intimidates them. And that's kind of a concept that the apostles had. They were sold to God. They did not trade anything with anything except God. Whether they're wives or children, whatever it is, pleasures, treasures. That's where I want to be. And God, if God allows me, and he will not worry me, that's why I want to drive you today. Where you don't see your money as important, where you raise from tithing to becoming a tithe yourself, where you move from being commanded and reach a stage of death. Because when you reach that time, you no longer mind where they take you, because a dead body doesn't know nothing. If we reach that stage, then we shall see God. And I think that's the awakening we are talking about. Going back to the original preordained purpose of God concerning our lives. I am prepared, I'm set, and I'm going to share with you. Not share the word, but I want also to share what you receive too. I'm also following. I don't know where he's taking me. There's a scripture in the Bible which says that who's blind except my servant? When I first read those scriptures, I said, wow, does God want us to be blind? Then I realized, yes, a blind person depends on the guide. They cannot move until they are moved. So, to become a thorough servant of God, you must be totally deaf and blind. That when you just depend on that stick or that what they call the guard dog. They take you where you don't want to go because you don't see. For the things that pertains to your life, you can see. Purpose concerning making choices, you can see. But if you want to touch that Shekinah glory, the glory that will rob your mindset, the glory that will not see your salary as something important, the glory that will kill you, you need to die, you need to be blind. I may not succeed to win all of you this morning because I'm not God, but a few of you today, there's going to be an encounter in your life. I'm not another preacher standing here. I count my days. I no longer see myself as one that has so much time. I'm 56. With that age, you see yourself. It's only the fools who don't see. But when you reach that age, you need to be cautious. Apart from that also, I've learned to know the meaning of life. The meaning of life is sharing life. That's it. Before I pass on, because all of us will pass on, but we need to pass on. Many times when people speak like that, we come to that level of death. I don't want to go down there with it. Pass it on. And all of us, we had about 20 preachers stood here. Each one passed on what they had. I was reserved for this day, not because of the plan, but because of what God wants to do. And because of the vision and the dream he gave about to the man of God about awakening. We need to reach that stage of soldiers. Michael Chimuli, go to Japan. Yes, sir. Tamare, go to Karamoja. Yes, sir. Without reasoning. That obedience when you are just going for your work and God says, go to church now. And yet you have an important meeting, a board meeting. God says, go to church. So today I want to kill everyone today. If I can succeed to kill you. You see how we struggle to build churches? You see how we struggle to even pay our rents? Not because money is not there. People are still alive. But people are still alive. They can spend for what they want to do, build apartments, buy more lands. But concerning the things of God, they are dead. You need to. They are alive. Today, Sidemai, if Sidemai doesn't change today, this man is going to struggle forever. But by the grace of God, all the services that we'll encounter here, this one, the next one, and the other one, we will be around. It's not going to so much be about singing and groups of singing. Today is a day to die. I died. You see Bunju and Sarah, but we died somehow. Even if people hurt us, we died. We don't even feel that they have hurt us. Living people will always say, Anesitaza, I'm for me, because you are still alive. Today is your day. I'm not talking about these tears we cry in meetings. Something's gonna change, and take you to where God wants to be.
We are standing on holy ground.
I want to hear everybody.
And I know
I can't hear you.
There are angels.
Everybody follow. Will stay, but the singers can come down. There is none like you. Hey. Can't touch my heart like you do. I will search for all eternity, God, and find there is none like you. Amen. Thank you very much. You may be seated. We want to welcome everybody online joining us live here at Kololo CDMI with Dr. Poso Chimuli and Sarah Bunjo and the great team here, pastoral team. This is the day the Lord has made. And of course, when the Lord has made something, the next thing is rejoicing. Can you welcome the presence of God? Come on, clap, clap your hands to Jesus. I'll be talking about three G's for greater glory. Three G's for the greater latter glory. If you're writing, this is CDMI, we are discipling ministry. Three G's. If you can put it on the screen, three G's for greater latter glory. When you talk about awakening, comes from the word awake. Simple English. Wake up. So that means you are still alive, but you are inactive because you are sleeping. I like the color you have used because it's a color of harvest. It's a harvest time for this ministry. Bubango ina sekuli tarawandi kubuna bibwa wanu wewe usoka. This is a season, Pastor Chimuli, Dr. Chimuli. The challenges you've gone through as far as building that temple at Chira. If you have anyone that you feel like they have hurt you, none of them have hurt you. It is me, God. Because the power of light is dispersed in darkness. The greater the dark, the greater it becomes darker, the greater the light. The greater the opposition, the greater the acceleration. CDMI, that the one you took or you knew, you have to go some other 3 days by yourself before Christmas. Because there's a new set of laws I want to create for you. The principles that I showed you when you are starting CDMI have been exhausted. If you go on carrying those, you're going to be like others. You're going to fail. 3 days, non-fasting of food, just silence. Enjoy your food. Get somewhere. Switch off your phone. Just keep quiet. I'm going to give you, before the end of the year, CDMI as a building is not the ministry, but that is a structure spiritually God wants to do. As you've done a new structure, I'm going to bring a new structure in this ministry. Thank you. A structure that will be able to work, that will be equal to the glory I'm going to bring. Every time before I bring increase, I create and build the capacity. Any straight building depends on how many floors gains its strength in the foundation. Your team has been praying. You've been praying with your leaders about the excellency, the greatness of your ministry. But you forgot another part, that some of the people will leave. Not for bad. Because there's a pruning that's coming in this ministry. And Michael, stand as a man, not as a man of people. Why I'm taking you is not the Michael they know. The Michael who has been a pastor is now putting on a mantle of an apostle. I know they've been calling you apostle, but the apostleship is taking its shape. Because the structure of CDMI is not like a local church. It is a structure that is going to hold many, many, many churches, where it requires you to mentor, delegate, inspire. So, awakening was not so much about the people, it was so much about you. We have enjoyed this week, people have cried, but it is you. This message was for you. But you are so generous to share it with the people. But it's you. I'm building a church that will be able to stand the test, because things are going to become more worse in the world. And so many churches are going to stay as churches, but church of the world. So Marcus Tala brota Kisina Ukraya. So I have allowed everything to happen, to prune. Pruning is simple. The explanation is somebody goes to their garden and begins to cut off those dead, unfruitful branches. It's painful to allow growth, not so? To allow growth. So there's a pruning. Bidingi with Bakatusina Ikuna bin Tasa Yebikolaya Kutokun. A pruning beginning with you to have stamina. Look at what happened at Garden City. When they were doing Garden City, they constructed it. The proprietors didn't really think that that place will grow to the level of having many vehicles, because that was one of the first shopping centers in Uganda, as you know. But 4-7 years ago, if you remember, they started redigging the foundation of the existing foundation, putting other side pillars, because now they are going to put another floor, you remember? The one now when you want to access it, you go up there. So they wanted, because customers were now running away, going away, because the capacity of parking was low. So they had to go down. Go down to go up. That's the principle. Every time you want to go up, you must go down. And today, they can at least have many cars, and many shops have come up. When I promised Abraham that he's going to become a father of many nations, I think in his mind he thought that, he was going to see all the stars that he saw up there. But Abraham had no capacity. But he was a father of that nucleus. And God told him, your children, your descendants will go to Egypt. And they will spend there 400 years. Then afterwards, they will come to this place. The promised land that they were promised is the land that Abraham sojourned. But while he was there, he didn't have legal right. Kanani yenyini kuyatambulirako. Yaitamu yali apangisa upangisa. And the Amalekites were there. God says, you go there because the sin of the Amalekites have not come to the full measure of punishing them, because I'm a God of justice. I cannot give you their land until they have angered me. So, bachanyiza, sinaba chinyizo cha batina kuruka jendi. So, 400 years, God is developing a nation in a nation. A nation has to have sovereignty, and sovereignty has to be, they needed to have army. They needed to have leadership. They need to have numbers. Education. So he drives them to Egypt, the superpower of that day, the first world power where civilization started. Listen, and they were there for 400 years building capacity. Yes, they suffered, but he was raising numbers, because you cannot own be a nation with two people. It has to do with numbers. By the time they were ready, Moses was born to take them back. So some of you guys, the things you say, this has delayed it, you know, no. that delay and those oppositions, you yourself being built as a capacity to be able to hold. That's why today Israel can never fail to be anywhere, because they suffered so much that in their DNA and blood, they can be anywhere. And that was happening in Egypt. Don't worry about here, this place. Do not worry about this place. Eat your food. Drink your water. Don't even fast. If I want you to be here, I want you to be here. If time for you to go, do not hesitate. That's why God told you, immediately after this conference, get somewhere for 3 days. Because even to be in the Kugamba, be in the Kukabia, but be in the Kuinvolvinga, be in the Kuinvolvinga, Okukutula Kuchova Doyagala. But I cannot speak to you now. I needed you to prepare you. Don't worry about this place, neither the other one. I am the one in it. Just follow me. Support him in prayers, because now the okweyongera okwamwe konna kuli kuono. Mumu sabiringa butamu sabirangako. Mumu guardingenge butamu guardingangako. Kubanga waita waziba ino lubuto lunene ate bwataluzala. Bwalwawo kuluzala sedi ya mwai genda kufukanga makanisa amalala. All things are possible, cause we believe. Lord, I believe. Lord, I believe. All things are possible, cause I believe. So, can you imagine how God is? It was the color. I saw the color of the theme, and the prophecy came. There's something coming. But you need to be prepared. This ministry is flying. Huh? Before Boeings fly, they start small, reverse, then they turn. What are they doing? They are locating the runway. Some planes carry 400 people, and these are expatriates. These are pastors. But it is going to fly, and it's going to be cruising maybe 500 kilometers per hour, flying over 33,000 feet above sea level. But when it is taken off from the terminal, it's a small truck that pushes it. It takes over 20 minutes to those big runways. That's where you've been. And in that runway, why are they doing that? They don't want any destruction. They make sure that the people on the control tower, no plane lands. Or something's going to take off. If you can feel what I feel, that will be the best service since when you started this ministry, this service here. And they make sure nothing's there, because the plane is taking off. And it's a season for that. The season to break camp is now. The season to let others go is now. The season for compromise is now. To stop compromise is now. The season to be harder for God is now. And that will determine the destinies of all your passengers in this plane. Good news for everyone here. Your destinies are safe if this captain takes the plane off in time. If he doesn't, the control tower will tell you, go back to the terminal because there are other planes taking off. God bless you. But why you get a mukama se? Ah! Chitif. Can we read that theme or heading together? 1, 2, 3, go. Are we ready? If we can't finish now, we shall come to the next service. And if you can't, we shall come to the next service too. So today is a day that we are going to be here for God. May not be different from the previous years as far as challenges are concerned. Everybody is waiting. 22 is coming. 23 is coming. 24 is coming. Yes! The world is going to be better. I'm here to say, as a man, as a prophet, the world itself may not be better. And it's not going to be better. And if it has been, that has been your prayer, I'm here for you to change it. Because the whole world, is anxiously waiting before Jesus Christ comes. The systems of the world are trembling. The devil himself is trembling because the season is no longer there and the time is run out. So the world itself, and when I talk about the world, it's a system. It is anxiously waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God. Let's first read that scripture in Romans. Chapter 8. Let's begin with verse 12. Can we read together, please? 1, 2, 3, go. Therefore, brethren, we are debtors, not to the flesh, but to live according to the flesh. For if by... Go on. Uh-huh.
You can jump. Okay, go on. Witness, we are that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs. Heirs of God. And join heirs with Christ. If indeed we suffer with him, that we may also be glorified together. For I consider that the suffering... Can you put your voices up, please? 1, 2, 3, go. For I consider that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us. For the earnest... For the earnest expectation of creation eagerly waits for the revealing of the sons of God. Go on. For the creation. I think we are many. We can channel it out. Thunder. 1, 2, 3, go. For the creation of subject to futility, not willingly, but because of him who subjected it in hope. Because the creation itself also will be delivered from the bondage of corruption into the glorious liberty of the children of God. For we... Until now. Say it again. Not only that, but we also who have the first fruits of the Spirit, even we ourselves groan within ourselves, eagerly waiting for the adoption, the redemption of our body. You can't stop there, thank you. Bible says the glory of the latter. Temple will be greater than the first one. We live in the seasons of his coming. Maranatha. Meaning, come back. Now, everything in the world, including us who are waiting for him, the earth and the creation is groaning. Why? Because somebody who subjected it, Adam, subjected it to futility. We suffer. We groan. Even the earth itself, remember them was afraid to gender. Even the creation itself, the trees, the aviation, the solar system, the marine, the wildlife is suffering because of the greed of man. Now they are saying that this global warming is because of these superpower nations which create these bizungirizi. The ozone layer, that flap that covers the earth between the sun and the earth, which condenses light to have the pure light and good light, heat, is being torn apart. So, even the earth itself, the creation, the creatures, the animals. Look at what's happening in the wildlife. How people kill animals anyhow. How people are cutting trees anyhow. No respect for creation. Everything is groaning in the name of artificial intelligence. Everything is groaning. And what both humans and the creation are waiting. Nyambako. They are all waiting for the manifestations of the sons. And the word son here is not a gender thing. It is a spirit. Bible says he has given us a spirit of adoption, a spirit of sonship. This is woman. Man, when you receive the spirit of God, you receive the spirit of sonship. The problem is that even the church that is supposed to have sons who speak out, who speak to darkness, who say no, have been marred with the worldly system. We think worldly. Even the church will operate worldly. The way we handle our finances, worldly. Everything is worldly. That's why you, man of God, you put this awakening. Awakening simply means go back. Nothing new. Wake up. When I sleep very well, and I sleep as John Bunjo. I don't wake up at Sakwa. Whether I sleep in Germany or Mombasa, whatever it is, when I sleep, it is John Bunjo. I'm supposed to wake up as John Bunjo. Meaning, when God says, awake, it's not a new revival of laughter. He's not talking about a revival of artificial grace, internal grace, or everlasting grace. No. One thing, God wants us to shine again as sons of God. Because it is you and I that is going to deliver your clan. That is going to deliver your husband. Come on. Fill that gap. Your workmates. The whole world is what? For the earnest. Read together. For the earnest expectation of God. Eagerly wait. I wish I can. They are all waiting. It is waiting. Who is going to save? You know, the trees are waiting. Enyanja abantu bakati bakwata n'obunyanja buto bakola buli kintu kirinda. Because sons of God will preserve the sea. Sons of God will preserve their animals. Bible now you guarantee. Omuntu ukirivu alabirira bulungi ensolo ye. Emiyo gye ekimama kino kikube kino kivume gye emiyo gy'abaana abali abaana bafuuka enzikiza. Buli kintu kirinda. Ne gavumenti zonna zirinda abaana atufuga nga bali mu musana. Ba administrator abanajja nga bali mu musana. Abasumba abanajja nga bali mu musana. Siba na abakonjera na abawayira. Abantu abanayogera ebigambo nga bali street. Abatuma abanayogera ebintu nga tebali biasness. So, God in this scripture through Paul has not said he is waiting for the big church. A church that has vehicles, about hundreds of them outside there. Oh, with people are putting on very well. No. Oh, with the TV station. Is waiting for the revelation. For what? For the revealing. The word reveal simply means there's something concealed. Everybody say concealed. And it takes revelation to open something. Something has been concealed. We need a critical eye. Mama. For the world itself is ready to oppose the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The new world system, the global agenda, they have already done. Their preparations are done. Everything is ready, but the church is sleeping. We are busy singing hymns, dancing. Olwe chivade chijewa na msumba nga mpulida. Nte kanisa elibize imba. Elibize teka teka ama zimba gama yeka alwa mapia. Elibize teka teko kwa deini ngaba tumeneba nabinaba dinkon. Neite vama njijia. And see, the world is more prepared. The globalists are now setting up, they already set up a new world religion coming soon. Fabasoma. The systems of economy are already in place. Yeah. You can't do anything now. They will locate you where you are. Go to Google Earth and ask anything here, even if it's in Uganda. Before, it was, if you want to come to my home, I have to direct you kyamira kayumba kembizi yitira wabajirira ki umsajja wali atunde mumbwa uliokuwa tuke wangu. Today you just send what? Location. Send your location. We are all organized to be disorganized. The system has organized us to disorganize us. They tried it in COVID. It had never happened for church to close. They tried it for 2 years, but not as a persecution, but as a trial. I mean, oh, praise the Lord. We came back. Sometime we may not come back. So that's why I want to upgrade you from being members of Sidemai, oh, whoever is watching us, but becoming disciples. Am I clear here? That's why the issue, I'm a member of CDMI. I'm a member of CDMI. No. You are a disciple of Christ. God can take you anywhere because you are the disciple of the global church. That's why recently God told me, re-register people in Bombo, that small congregation lead, and begin to sensitize that we have already started a vigorous exercise that none of our members is gonna warm the chair. We are launching out something that will cause every believer who pops, who comes in that church in Bombo, to be a witness, a disciple, not a member. Membership has killed us. Members have done more harm. They don't want to go, but they still want to pull us down. They're in the church, they don't go, but they are telling people things that are stupid. But a disciple will honor their pastor. A disciple will give him their money for the work of God, even if they will not even pay their rent until this rent is paid. That's what they call disciples. They told Jesus told them, do you want to go? Say, where? We can't go anywhere because you have the words of life. And you are not ready to give you anything, but even not only give you our things, but even give you our lives. Kandawa banchi koze bulungi. Bambi uli leri, ninjagala bileta mu order. You are not a member. Members have married many wives. Members have put themselves to marriage. Who are your sister Chichimusuma? They cannot manage in for her, they are members of the church. Members bring antagonism. Trying to break a great relationship. Those are members. Killers, stupid people. But a disciple will fear even to backbite you. A disciple will not even eat their tithe. They are not tithing because it is written. They are following the instructions from inside, not from outside. So now, we are in the business of upgrading from membership to discipleship. And moreover, Sidemai. Remember Sidemai. Do you know what Sidemai means? Okay. How many knows? This is abbreviated. What is the meaning of Sidemai? Raise your hand. The words in Sidemai. Can I see your hands? Jagari miri yako sebo. Ola bechi ntucho. Mwene kanise jude babu. Members, Christian Discipleship Ministries International. Which means everybody here must be a firebrand. But again, that will take a courage. It's not easy. So, the whole world, everybody say the whole world.
is crying, not for the coming of Jesus. No, for the manifestation. They are there. They are there, but they are covered. They are sleeping. They think, for me, I'm not a pastor. For me, I give money. And yet they don't even give much. Why are you being everywhere? Try somebody. You know, for me, I'm a CEO. You are supposed to be a light to that place. I'm not talking being appearing here every day. No. Your appearance here doesn't approve your discipleship. It's the way you behave outside. What do they see? Pray for us. The Britons came here and left, but they discipled us. As I talk now, I'm in Uganda, but I'm speaking English among the people, black. They will never come back here. They don't need to come back here. Yeah. Look the way he put on this, put on today. This is not African. Look at this madman. This is pure English. Look at your children now. None of you want your children to speak Luganda now. Children who have grown up here, they don't speak your language. You feel bad when they speak your language. They discipled us. They left. But the church has failed to disciple. When Pastor Chimuli talks about the culture of Baganda, whatever, people go out of church. The church has not come inside. We are professors, but not actors. The Britons, look at our parliament, how it's built. Everything. They lived. That's what I desire. Pastor Chimuli, nebota kuita kubipande kubirekera au, kwata kabina ako kano. Nangi chena kote bombo. Nangi yaga dokumala ude wange bombo inyokati. Nange mba mateze nga abangereza. Nga buli afuruma. Gama buli afuruma. Kade mwako. Tasobola. Kati wano na yazo kubi nangu wano. Ya tukubile nangu wafi. Ya bada ya mazi okusaba. Daddy. Bangambi. Nino kujia kusidia mwayo lwalero. Bansabi. Choki. Kubanga nze mkuziza. Tasobola mwala gapala. Ngaba nabapala. Ateka tebansa sude bulunji. I've mentored him. He was a Muslim, that young man. This Joel here. Look at this Sam, the group here. Where can Sam go? I don't have you demo kubanga abamanta zaba tubama mentoring. Tuagala kuleta aba professional. If we can focus on CDMI membership and no brooding for 4 years, ngeno jeba kuita eba optional, no taking a time wano. Ako Jesus, you are going to see power. If Jesus only had 12 minus 1 and he spent 3 years with them, neka tuina ba maleto ono ate wakayanja atali msidi mai atoli waseroda msidi mai tuina ba maleto banchi vule yogere chigambo tuweyo atende bazigabanya gama ne bazigabanya kubanga tuba nenya kubanda fetu tuba wadibudi. Tetuba wade budde kebea mirako center kinchogera TV ulida kebea CDMI. We need now to take time. Everybody say take time. You pastors, spend time with your people to separate those who are visitors and those who are disciples. Not control them because that's bad, but feed them. Nibatu batu inebanja liya milo ni chikumi. Oba bibiri.
bana batudde wano basobola naye tebannakulya kimala
awo newaba akasiriikiriro naye The next 4 years, I want to spend time with people that I'm going to.
Njagaliwa babunjo ngabina. Na yabo ngile babo budi. Katipasa chimuli na weke ni ingie no teko mire ilu.
Everybody say manifestation. Kade mwako? Chidemwela? Chidemwela? The word manifest is not creation. Something is there. Huh? All of us have gifts that have not manifested. That's why we are now using this conference. Wake up. Judith, wake up. Tamale, wake up. Solomon, wake up. Bible says, one will chase 1,000. Meaning, we need to reach that level that each one of us in this church, whoever is watching us, is not just following, but has followers too. So, everybody say manifestation. Revealing of sons. But these sons are there. All of us got born again, but we do not know what we have. That's why God is telling us to raise up. So what are the 3 G's before I finish? For this service, then we shall continue. This service I've done introduction. The next one I'll do service. I'll preach, teach. But let me say this. The first word G stands for glow. Write it down. Glow. Glowing. Have you put it there? Not grow. Glow. Glowing. Is it glowing? What does that mean? To shine with awe, as if with an intense heat. Embers glowing in the dark. This morning, as I woke up at 6:30, my house faces the east. I don't know how it happened. I see the sun when it's setting up from the east. I could see that yellow, that yellowish light. It was glowing through all my windows. You're glowing. That breaking of the morning, it's a simple, small glow, but discards darkness. Ooh, all the night, people fear to go out. They can't get out. But at 5:30, you begin to hear birds welcoming the glow. They say, oh my goodness, the morning is coming, oh Lord. The frogs, because they say, ha, now we are seeing, we are waking up again, we are seeing light once again, we are celebrating once again. They hang, that's why the English call that morning food breakfast. Because in the night we are fasting, busy having dreams, going back to your house, running up and down. Hallelujah. What are you talking about? I'm flying. Simple. You're dreaming a car. You have a dream driving a car. That is a ministry. My brother, why is it ministry?
Siyoro jono. Gwemuuliza kuma radio ya wano nyinyo. Radio bunji. Senga mukendeza kubo radio. Tuandi wonye. Luli tuwaina. Before tuwaidu bulu unji nge kanisa. Ovamu kanisa odamu kanisa. Nye katibu radio buli nkaga. Pasa chimuli asome sa deliverance. Aza na aposu. No jitegira. Na yuri na gamba bulikantuko na kauka muzimu. Echienje muzimu. Mbwe ise kaba muzimu. Ziba ze ya gara sera chakurundu gamu isamba. Kakati nubuza. Zozi liye ya gara kodi tuzi itile faya. Nechono chivalose nalose. Bunji honga aliko echiwa yechimu. Uyuzo kwa gamasu. Manyi uyuzo kwa webase otunula. Katingoli wote. Chiringa bubanga webasenga ofunya magulubu otinga ofunye boti oloto ogwa nchitegera chegamba because obanga omusulo gukuluma cheche bawo oloto okola susu ninga tavayo ngumulabo mukola gama ndo mukola na yingula bate tavayo kero kumaliza ngo susu linze kubulili kati nacho chiite chiroto musulo gwa bade gukuluma tamali Nkusaseza bwo sasa obaga mazima genjogere. Kibula ba bera ko musumba guonywa. Ntikati nywa bunjo na chimuli full stop tombuli abalala. Ona katikati banana buluganda we have to be born again and again nzude ye kisate chiruwa. Uli muguwa dalu ina mageza gategera. Aha Bible gamba etya I am the way kidemo jo. Mudemo namwe I am. Aha. And what? Olabye wo hyper grace awo. Oba great grace, saving grace. Table in grace. Jesus is the truth. One body of the other. Twice a year, and I can use the same business as you would. Naloko came here, na yes. Oba agenda kujja kunsi ya je. Ora yangamba. My yes, agenda kujja aje kunsi. Tuwele kono nemuga ya. Ati chini njia nzima. Ansinga nemu nyumba yangu mbere mu forever. Na ganti. Hey, nemuga nzima sina buta wana bwana jioni jikula. Kajok manya tuwali chiva. Do wali zero. We praise the name of the Lord. Ati mani, you know, they are two witnesses. Semeni, lukaga nkaga mukaga. Ati kati semeni vaccination. Ati sende chile mera wano. Ibi chumai bi WhatsApp ugabeji si uli disebi. Ati kati bana wachujia. Ati kati bitu wigeda. Ati kati 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 sabazi gade. Lukaga nkaga ze. Kati teza sabazi gude yala ze. Lukaga nkaga mukaga. The old world is crying. Say with me. The old world is what? Crying. Families are crying in there. I know your husband has gone away. I know you have challenges with place of work, but you are the one to glow. Hallelujah. Ato mami again, anti uinzo kwa tewe isabulunji. Te wakuba mweso. Uyambaranga boya gala. Glow in your bedroom. What are you talking about? Shout hallelujah, somebody. Glow in your kitchen. Shout hallelujah. Glow in the bathroom. Buli chintu chagweri naka nzagweri bi computer bya glow everything glow everybody say glow This is introduction next service I'm going to put this into perspective
Ababa cha mukama Malakai chapter 4 mbu enjube yobutukirivu kada Eri bakola tia. Eri bavira yo. With healings. And that morning is now. Tante gedori abada kubye takubye. Jidem. That morning is now. Can you say it louder? Can we read together? 1, 2, 3, go. Uh-huh. Together ku verse 1. Verse 1. Verse 1, verse 1, verse 1. 1, 2, 3, go. For behold, the day is coming, burning like an oven, and all the proud, yes, all who do wickedly, will be stumbled. And the day which is coming shall burn them up, says the Lord of hosts. That will leave them neither root nor branch. But, 1, 2, 3, go. The Son of Righteousness, with what? Healings in his wings, and you shall go out. And grow fat like stone-fed calves. Chevdemba gamba mpointi yangu introduction. Endwa lezigenda kwa yongera. Kwa usibu nabi kwa yense tide virus yonabi vayo.
but we shall survive in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Economies are going to be turned upside down because everything is running away. But amidst this one, when you're going to call it a point, amidst all that, God wants to see the sons of righteousness rising up. Shout hallelujah, somebody. Somebody shout hallelujah. That's why the Bible says, even though, let's say it together, Psalms 23, 1, 2, 3, go. Even though I go through, come on, 1, 2, 3, go. Even though I go through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil because thou. There will be COVID-1, COVID-3, COVID-5, COVID-19, COVID-77. But for those who fear the Lord, everybody say with me, those who fear the Lord. There will be a glowing. There will be a glow. Like these guys that mine copper. Where they are mining copper in Kirembe, it's very dark. But when they enter there, what do? They have the light on. They begin to dig in the dark. And in the dark, they get riches where people don't see. These people see why they have a light. I know darkness has taken over our money, has taken over our marriage. But now the Lord is telling us to put on our light once again. Go now, save your family, save your home. Shout hallelujah, somebody, save up. Let your light shine. The anointing of God in this place. It is in the dark. That's why the Bible says, I will give you authority and power to get and acquire the wealth of the darkness. Of darkness. Yes, it's dark economically, but the church has been built without anything. Praise the name of the Lord. For me, I prospered almost 70% above what I used to be 2 years ago. Personal and ministry. My ministry has never had surpluses. Neither I. Like in COVID times. What was that lesson? That even though the churches were closed, the heavens were not closed. Even though the economies, because you, we are coming back. As we shall finish that in time there. There are so many scriptures of that and time is on. That glory and the glowing will produce growth. Number one, grow. What is the purpose of light, Mr. Tamari? One of it in plants. What is it about plants? What does light help plants? Manufacture food. As the light of God that you have in you begins to come out to the place where you work from, to your former boyfriend, that light. That boyfriend will even fear to send you messages because they see light. Sajanta wanya anti uri nechizikiza. Wamujja ko sendezo omwana okusoma. Izu kati chichimu kwesi byako. Hasajja bankwa na agenda ga obalaga inakala sole ko balaga. My finances have trouble because there's darkness in your giving. Let there be light. Count your tithe. In fact, don't become even a tither. For me, I'm no longer a tither. I'm a tithe. Because I give beyond. I'm the biggest donor in my ministry. Me. And Sarah Bonjo. That's why the economy is lost. They no longer control me. Let the light of God shine. Nobody lights a candle and puts it under the whatever. What? What do they do? My sister, what do they do? They put it. For those of you are going, and if you can't stay, we shall get another chairs. In fact, this service today, but joining the service, because this is the last day. Kicheche kutwala kuzika. Kufumbira mwami. This is a conference. Conference phase 1 away day. tugenda kutereza tuwebyewayo ebisooka tugenda mu conference phase 2 ne phase 3 and with this your life will never be the same again. As I intensify to teach about that, that light will bring growth. After that light has brought growth, what is next? Go. Can you say it? Go. So number one is glowing. That's the glory of God. And grow. That's discipleship. Go. That's evangelism. So that is what is going to bring the latter glory. Because the latter glory now, Judith ajagenda eri muri company ya Binzika. Ngatagenda nga HR. Nenga bayogera what? Baina chebalaba bonna batya. Bakuitan? Babula nga bwagenda balaba okuva ku mviri paka ku mutwe. And people will be joining church. They are coming, they come for it. And said in it is again the kutala, chuja chogera face dako. Tezigenda kutala ya tadoba. Go watch my little Malik service.
Insane. Gamba, Jensen, the Zigenda Kutalaya Tadova. Zigenda Wali Gulo. Zigenda Wali Chi? Gulo. Come here, Zoo. Can we give a hand clap to the Lord Jesus Christ? Another hand clap to the man of God. As we move from glowing to growing and going, can you tell your neighbor, try your level best to be available. Chimugambo, you are taking a change, you're getting a CDMI. The entire CDMI is busy. And they wake up during lockdown. They sleep after lockdown. During lockdown, they are all awake. You put on Zoom, everyone is there. They come back, they sleep back in their work. I mean, pretending to be busy. One day I was speaking to pastors. I said, every time we are in a meeting of pastors, they are running somewhere, you know, and they even deceive, even pastors, fellow pastors deceive on the pulpit. You know, Pastor Chimuli is not easy. You cannot get him. Nembaga mulekera okumpayiriza. Mwe mwe wairiza. Buli omu mulaba duka. Abantu nabo baduka nga balaga. Omuntu tubutali mu lugambo gambo. Bintu ebigendo basula. What did we do? You people used to be in churches, up to evening. And they are working. Actually, most of the people who are in those big places now, who used to be part of World Trumpet Mission, they could be in church up to morning until 10 in the morning. You know. But Buza Yakurina Mugendi Mumukurachi. What exactly are you doing? And where is the money? The Mugamba Mukola 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 and Tulimu Tent. Tulimu Tundubari. So you better come and get to know God. Amina. Mukama Yevaziwe. We want to give. We want to give and. The Bible says in the book of Luke, chapter 6, verse 38, give and it shall be given unto you. Give and it shall be given back unto you. And how? Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. If you give, what will be given back? Good measure. Pressed down. Today I want you to look at that scripture very critically. Not sing it, you know, everywhere in new people. Give and it shall be given together. No, give and it shall be given back to you. That what? Good measure. Number two, pressed down. Three, shaken together. And running. But me kama liba koze ku shaking over no in sao. No, you come here. Nemwanyi. Nalinte mye kubikajjo ebya walakira muholide nengenda okutema ebikajjo teri mulimu gwankalubiriza ngaogwo naye nga nnoonya ssente ffe twakola buli kintu nawakanadduka obuddusi maama gwe nagamba nga togamba taata kuba taata ajja kugamba taata ffe tetukola ebyo tuli basajja baganda mujja kutuswaza neŋamba oluyimba ngenze kukola ssente netwewaana tugamba tumenye netulaba netubala netugamba zino lwolwekkumi abaana gyokulikka ku lwolwekkumi mumanyire olwekkumi abasajja bakasuka ebikajjo ku lwole nezivaamu bbiri nenzingako obwange nenfuluma esamba nenga nvudde ku bikajjo galina engeri gyakakwata nakakuba mu lolwe cwi nekabuliramu cwi ngenda okulaba nga lwolwekkumi ziggwawo eventually they were two ten that's what they call pressed down naye nga twayise mu mazzi ebikajjo bikusala omubiri gwonna twagenda okuvayo nga gwonna tegufaananika atebe mutye emisota tetukoze ebintu ogenda tuli abaana b'omulembe guno nga balowooza booti bwota even peter yo n'abazaalibwa mu ngeri endala but give and it shall be given unto you what good measure pressed shaken and then and running over shall men tell you neighbor men every time I give I have realized God does not rain from heaven it he will use someone that you least even expect and he will surprise you to oh bana ebintu byokugaba bino ebinsanyusiza katonda akwesa omuntu nogamba my god era tuteka kuteeka wantu maaso shall men give into your bosom for nakano tukasome kasome kana kasemba for with the same measure that you do what you use it will be measured back to you. You used to get 1 million a month, now you are getting 3 and you are still giving the same measure. Echo mukama nze yachinga ngamba buli anze ngamba techiri yo maiko bobera wantu wona ne bobera wa CCDMI akapapula kasinga obunene nga njogera amazima munsawo yange nze nalekerawo kuwa red the least I can give in offering ekyo mukama yangamba try it nga ngambye I want to build CDMI church ebyo byebimu byanatandikiramu okugonda nangamba do not go down I'm going to open the windows and I saw him do it mukama yebazibwa I saw him do it can you take out your offering put it in that envelope I want us to give please want us to give siganga ensigo nja manyi bali kubulu siga kawungezi siga nechiro leta makungula munyumba ya Yesu tulisanyuka nga tulese binywa eri Yesu tulese binywa tulese binywa tulisanyuka nga tulese binywa tulese binywa tulisanyukanga tulese binywa siga kawungezi sigo kwekikome tojikisa mpewo n'obunyogovu ekiseera kijja lwali twanukula Yesu tulisanyuka tulisanyuka nga tulese binywa tulese binywa tulese binywa tulisanyuka nga tulese binywa kwebaza mukama olw'abantu bano bonna abawadde obawa omukisa emikono gyabwe giwa omukisa obasanyuse obajjukire mukisere cho kukabiramu bibe ganti mulete obweyamo bwamwe nokwebaza kwa mweli mukama mubire byo kulabe naku munkowole nange ndi banukula mukama okikole ekyo mulinya lya mukama afa Yesu amen azokuteka ekiwebwa ekyo mukibe ekisinga okumpi naye nga sigenti yimuka bove ugende tekawo butezi tekawo ku speed ugwe kibbo kyolabe kiri okumpi. There is a near basket, a nearby basket. You are not giving going out, you are giving to sit back. Give, and sometimes the Bible doesn't say which kind of gift or offering or whatever. Bible bwegamba okuwa teyogera kika kya kugabaki. Giving alms to the poor, giving offering in the church, giving contribution to the projects, but give with the same measure, it will be measured back to you. Amina. Ulida, ejendu chenzude, what I have discovered. Apostle Kankubulieko, Uganda Jetulim. There is something I've discovered. People, and I've suffered with this ever since Obama trumpet. I am naturally not a pretender. I don't pretend not to have. I don't pretend not to be. Walu abantu abalunje nyonga kumulimu. Obutamutegera nti alina nga asobola okugula vaccination atambulira mu primo. Obamanya bwe bati. Nga yeyambaza yambaza ebigoye naye nga alina investment za amaanyi. Mukitegera ekyo. But I can't be that. Ever since I was a young boy, I was a smart young boy. Omuchara chimulio no yansanga ndi smart. Na naka yumba katonenga kayonjo nga ndi muyonjo muzibu. Eh? Kati nenga taka abalala nebandi disorganizing amwengera bagambi. Bajokuri gonga ndi disorganizing. When Samu ayingira ona afuruma ono John Mark atwala soksizo ona atwala ebintu bikozesa fena ekyanyamba bonna ebigere binene teri asitwala ngatto zange nabawona bampitako nabawona kati ngenda bawona kubira John Mark atasobola kwambala mpale yange kuba eyanga ajambala emirundi ebiri tweko okugatta eyange two times Samu tasobola ampiseko kanyama bingi kati bagenda mbawona nera nkyayina okutawana okutontono misipi bikibinta wanyi kubate bamanye ebintu byange bimbi babirungi kati I don't know how to pretend I've realized people always say ne daddy bwetuba tunakuwa tukuwaki gamba akulinanye muli bakodo CDMI eliyo musumba mbabu ulianza amazima ekyo nkimanyi very naye because nze nde ekirumu kama kyeyangamba nangamba there is a day I was actually what doing what I was in Kirindi Chiyindi. We went there on an overnight. And what were you in the chair? I don't know. Yatambura and Ganyon and Smenchamu Tukaku. Negatos and Alimunenzi Jam. Ganes won Vukanga and about Bambi as it again as it again. That is because of where Unganonjin you. Mugama Namamba Mutunuri and Muchuatongo Mississippi. O Manita Lichin, which is the word Yabasa Janga Gura Mississippi. Gusso Roku Guano Mutuna was no guy, yes. Chukira abasajja basidde mwe amagenti muambale ku Mississippi mutuyambe so kutuye omusajja nga alina obusobozi nga Mississippi gwagaana nga alina ogwo okumala emyaka 10 nja kujjano njulire ku njiri ya etiketi nga mulimu n'engeri omuntu gye representing chokka but in the chimpanzees out being presentable is really good but not being over smart not glamour I'm saying. But you know, people say, I even failed what to buy you. Chirio. Mukama yangamba, na ine sawa yanga ya benga nunji nyo na jigula ku cruise boat. Nga ngenze Finland. Mubimus duty free shops. Oguranga kuliko nempeta yako. Chinga nunji nyo nengama angule chine. Nga ngambe ine riemu na njigula. Mukama nangamba, pass tane mutu nina. Mukama nangamba, yu sawa jwe pass to you. Nga na yasi bie ndala. Nengamba mudobozi mukama nasibiye ndala mukana nga no nkugambye zebyo mbikoze nyo nga it's okay I'll give it out. Zijemu ama simu gange ndoza simu kadi vame ka iwo muntu ngaduri sitajite musana na musa na yenga mukama ngambi do it ye yali na reason mukama yebazimu chukira kulina anyomuge tuli na mu time ya Christmas yego kuwa ku bantu ebirabo soko chigamba kulina mugi yiga kuwa ku bantu ne mu church yo randomly siku gamba siku tunila muntu malo muntu yomanyi ama nze chemba dende tachichi na bantu bagala nyo kutunila bantu bambi tava munga temu bambi waluwe muntu kabato boyakula ninge mabega wali na famu satu ina apartment ngana ya pretending nze nchirabyeko mchacha bane babera ko goba pite inga piti 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 ne bamutu wala ne bamutu wala ne bamutu azwa no kubaruka no batu ya nogo okay you piti ekijja kuogera bingi ndabyeko n'abasajja ba Katonda abasumba abatoototo natandikira mu piti naye mu piti nagagawaliramu nga w'obujulizi bwe nava ku chit nava ku street nakola point nabeera wama kati bagenda omuzula nabagagga be nagenda olinanga sikyawagundi bintu ne mungariki nagenda kazula akakagagga nnyo gabadde ogabiramu ekyo obadde ogabiramu ekyo then you have a big problem. Then you have a very big problem. Can you tell your neighbor, please? Let's not do that. Now, there is something I want us to do. Chino, si chisabidwa, omukuru, alabi katachimanyi, na ye, we have a wonderful, wonderful wedding which we cannot fail to sow a seed in. Mchitegira chimbagam? Olwokubanga nze kambabuli nina ekizibu nalokoka naye mama tata wange yali muganda mama wange yali munyarwanda abanyarwanda balina enkola yaabwe mama wange yangamba toyogeranga ebintu byo to exposing nga nnyo byewetaaga nga yalina engeri eyo nga muntu ali very reserved nga afaanana munyo estoyo nga bwabeera bwat very reserved very closed agamba toyogera kati yanteekamu ekintu ekyo I don't go on nentwala pasta tamale bali kuba mazo kulaba babali na tithe jawe fana no bula pasta tamale wandi friday milioni 10 ayo gero banali chimugambi kaba muchala oba no I don't do those things why ndoze cho chava moyo character mfumbiza abana wano na yesi janga ku chituti ne bagamba mumpe nali chikoze nze ne chimuli ne njogera wane baga please contribute muulira buulizi ate nebaza mukama nti bonna baali ba mu lockdown ne batulifunayo lockdown endala n'abalala bagenderaawo nga naye sibatawanyiza sibesobola sina abantu basobola okwogererawo naye atulusobedde tulinga abajja okolera omwana w'embaga abapendo gwo tebasobola okwogera nze mbabuli yammwe temwogera kyukira kulina mugere nti gwe toyogera neither you can talk atulumba ku mirimu gyaffe akola bwati nze mbiwulidde aina ugenda tena musumba omuzu nakugereza musumba munno mwegundi tava wano na abakulu ina gamba ne kweka na parking gayo murugalu ogwe bage yanga musajja mama na gamba ye ne kweka ne nemera musenge nga aliawo mulujja ate yali ampiye kushera to na mana ngama nze mbade njaku lyako na I want to be you to be my friend I want you to be poso mulin bunjo ya mumanya yali na yali nabi agendo muwa wanted to eat with you dinner nemga sina budde ngenda kugundi nga mugaka nyo muno na mana ngamba ine wele me give you a dinner in cash milioni nangamba can we have breakfast nangamba ndi wanukisha tu come back mtuwalo nkaga uradayo milioni bili nangamba really I really want you to be my friend nenga nze ninechizibu sisi kika njingazi towa uli wabansi kamubala wabanja gazachi aranja gazachi na ntuwala ganyawa ni wakubado limuka gabira niyo ntuwala wa amina. So now we know that Apostle Bunjo has and the wife. They stay in a good, magnificent house. But there are things we cannot fail to do. Amen? Mukama yeba ziwe. The boy, atari wano gwaita Jojo Wero. Jojo is going to marry on the date of Saturday eno embaga etuusi abaana baffe kirungi obasindikira mu kitiibwa si kyekyo kirungi obasindikira mu kitiibwa and CDMI Apostle Bunjo is part of us, not only part of us, but you know he is to the ministry. Do you know that? Do you know that? Ngati temuchanye nyamitwe buli omu asirise. Amen. Kati mbadde sagala kuogera bigambo bingi kirira mu nsawo. I'm not saying pledge now unless you are a very smart person and you write something, pledge, and your number, and you bring it to me and you tell me I'm bringing on a Tuesday or on a Monday. But otherwise, can we do something as CDMI? Something special. Can we do something special? Someone can, let's give 200,000, 100,000, 500,000, 1 million. Chala msambe cho chitufu? Tuchikole? Amen. Mkama yeba zibwe. Kale, echo njagala tuchikole. Yemili la buyemilizi kuata monsa woyo. Jamu sente. Mkukiriza katyo zinde etele. Mkama kapula kandete. Yes? Eh? Si uli debu? Eh? Mobile money number. Aha, Joel Bamwanju de Murabi, Alinga Kabaka. Never even know about Lina Kalich and Nunja Bantabanya Rwanda Bambi, Bamama Bangi. Although Montuva Mwambaza Bamutona. I think about you die, a very niche. Montuva Mutaka Kotesi Kamuri. You never mutuous in Yam, but I'm coming ever soon. Kali, mobile money number to where you are. Julia, Karuchi, Karo Nabulime, Karo Nabulime Aliwa, Kara Tuwe Simuye, Nambai, Karo Tumwe Siga, she's a banker, she's just no. Bemba Mwe Sige, Chiba Checho. Kali, Madeni Saba, Mujimukemu ndete lekati mwena mwenuli ayo gede temwefula mwena tifena tulabi katuliba mobile abako zompa ugenti nandi wa data ano na hini naka satu ezisi gade nja kuweleza ku mobile manna mwena jindetila kati mwaba ndetila mujimukemu ndetele mwendete kusipidi sakala chogerila. You know, I have learned to sow seeds. You will have children and your children will have to marry. You have to sow seeds. Aposo Bunjo nkubulide nalinta wana ewange nembaga ngamanyi nze natya buti kuba nalebe waffe nga teri bulungi mbaga and I began ningamba omukyala ngenda kuyitanga mu office tusabira abantu betu wabana wano ogena soka namwita a real embaga ziva mu seed zizi no mbabulira kugamba oso wingira abana bonga tebana bana kuba and I've seen it work. Karo Nabulime's number is there. Muyimukenga mundetra sente. It is possible. You just get up unless you are going to use mobile. Abagenda kozesa mobile nawe mpubirako ogefe tuliba mobile mpubirako wa mobile ndabe agala kumbuza abuza batono nnyo katabala mundete the center wa musolo kuyimirira mangu nnyinyinyo temu omuntu osola kumala tolowoza nyonga oline mitwalo ja abiri ogayirwa kizino si nsigo ekitamala kibaki nsigo tuteko kusiga ensigo tuteko kusiga ensigo nze ne kintu kyenzudde sumba kastaba singa ensigo era ogenda okula mukyacho ogenda okula musumba iro kyo musumba ali waguru nnyo w'abantu nsigo naye agitegeera nsigo oyo Tamale Junior olabye oyo mulabye Apostle Bunjo gobadde obuuza yabadde amanyi nti Alvin ate ewata banete Pastor Tamale oba Alvin otekwa mu adoptinga n'Apostle Mulinde yangambo yo siye mwana wa Pastor Tamale ndiko kutandika okutambula ne gundi nani eri toyani mm-hmm. nina abalaba eninzi abeetuddeko kati worship team mwe mukolaki mwena mwamala okufumbirwa laba nno mulinde bazadde bamwe basowingira kale bazadde abamu sina balokole banasowinga ddi aba mobile money baliwa kanda baba mobile money mobile mumpanaikire mikono simu mujira byenu katengeri je mugendo kunzisa manyi muntu wabaso babage akuereza mobile nola bakakanuka kagudeko 50,000 yo ine chindu cho ulya eh yo ni maka atuwadde 5 mukama akuemba ge HTV mulinya lya mukama afesu nga isukulumye ngeja mu chiti icho no buwanvu bwalete no muwala nga muwanvu wata nakubera mu chiwato ato muwanvu nedachi nzimbere mai control ko maka ujiingiza ne wana sema control ze wana ageni nedda si muwanvu kada tene mbaga yinyumete yango muwala ali wana esta ngo etudde ko chi mobile money sam mobile eh mazama ke bamala bekola mo mulimo abana abato eh bono bonane bakola contribution yabo. This is a seed. Seed, seed, seed. Kama mulungi nange kangateko zinungata ngatira ko mwe size zange zempa ngati deko safa service zange ziba andala kama mulungi tuyimire ku maguru gafe and we stand on our feet. No, you will take it after. Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for this day. We want to thank you for the word that has come to us. Truly need that greater glory. This is the time to move from the anointing to glory. This is the time to move from excitement to the fear of God and trembling in your glory. Lord, I pray that you give each person here a visitation, a mighty visitation. Ekintu ekisinga tutawanya mukama abalokole bangi tebalina visitation ya Katonda, tebalina those encounters we used to get, those encounters that changed us, that turned us, that Lord, we have had encounters that have made us what we are, encounters that made us read the Bible, encounters that made us fellowship every day, encounters that made us pray, encounters that made us love brethren, encounters that made us breakthrough in different areas. So I pray today in the name of Jesus, give someone a mighty encounter in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We pray and the people say amen and thank you, Lord. Bless every hand that has given. Buli omu wajje muwe mugabirire aleme kwetaaga nate bakolere embaga z'abaana baabwe n'abamu abasize ku lw'embaga ezaabwe zibakolere mu linnya lya Mukama Yesu. Mukama, I can prove, I have a testimony that the seed principle works. And it works 100%. It's right 100%. And that is what I can never stop doing. Lord, do it and do it in Jesus' name. To everyone that has sowed the seed in Jesus' name. And the people say, amen. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Pastor Solomon, can you take, can you lead Apostle? Mulindenga ko omusumba fulume.